In this tutorial, we will review the Unetbootin utility and how to use it to create a bootable USB drive with a Linux distribution on it. In this case, we'll use BackTrack Linux. The same utility can be used to create a bootable USB drive with Redhat, Debian, Ubuntu, Fedora, or any other Linux distribution. What is Unetbootin? Unetbootin, or Universal Netboot Installer, is a utility used to create live USB drives that can install various Linux distributions. It supports live USB, which preserves changed files between reboots, so settings changes and downloads will still be accessible if you have to reboot. With Unetbootin, you can either download the Linux ISO image yourself, or just have the utility download the files from the internet automatically. What is BackTrack Linux? BackTrack Linux is a distribution based on Ubuntu and focused on network analysis and penetration testing. BackTrack is booted and run in live mode, so no installation is required. Let's install Unetbootin. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, enter unetbootin.sourceforge.net and press enter. If you prefer, you can also go to your favorite search engine, such as Google, and do a search for Unetbootin. The first link should be to this page. On the Unetbootin homepage, click the Download for Windows button. On the Download information bar, click the down arrow button to the right of Save, and select Save As. On the Save As window that opens, select the location to save the file. This does not contain an installer, it's just an executable. So wherever you save the file, that's where you should run it from. Let's select Desktop, and click the Save button. It's best to format the USB drive before running Unetbootin. Unetbootin won't format the drive. It will just dump the files on top of what is already there. To do this, click on the Windows Start button, and then Computer. Under Devices with Removable Storage, find the USB drive you want to use. Warning here, make sure that you have selected the correct drive. If you select wrong, you could delete wanted information. In my case, the removable drive is E. Right-click, select Format. The Format Removable Disk window will open. Make sure that FAT32 is selected for the file system. Ensure that Quick Format is selected. If it is unselected, it will perform a full format, which will take much longer. A full format is good for old drives that have been used heavily. Click the Start button. You'll get a warning telling you that you're about to erase all of the data on the disk. Click the OK button. It should only take a minute or two to quick format the drive. Once complete, click the OK button. Click the Close button to close out the format window. Let's start Unetbootin. Find the Unetbootin icon on the desktop and double-click on it. On the security warning window that opens, deselect Always Ask Before Opening This File, and click the Run button. The Unetbootin application window will open. Let's review the various information here. You have two options on how to install BackTrack, or another Linux distribution if you prefer. Option 1. Leave the distribution radio button selected. Select the first dropdown, and select what version of Linux you want to install. We will select BackTrack. The second option gives you options for the 32 or 64-bit versions using either the GNOME or KDE desktop interface. I recommend selecting the 32-bit version using the GNOME interface, as this is what I will be using. The 64-bit versions have an underscore x64 after them, and the 32-bit versions have nothing. Now what this option will do is automatically download the install files from the internet for us. We won't have to go download the files separately. Option 2, you can select the disk image radio button. You can then select an image file to use for the installation files. Clicking the Select Disk Image File button, you can browse for the image file and select it. If you have a flaky internet connection that drops frequently, you might want to download a torrent version of the Linux distribution to ensure it downloads correctly. If your connection drops out, a torrent will just pick up where it left off. If you selected disk image, make sure that you change it back to distribution, and that the version information is still set correctly. Look down at the bottom where it says, Space used to preserve files across reboots. BackTrack is based off Ubuntu, so this feature will work with it as well. This is space that can be used to save settings and files on the USB drive. Set what you want based on the drive size. Let's set it to 500 megabytes. Below the space option, it shows type. For type, you can select either hard drive or USB drive, depending on which you want to install it on. We will select USB drive. Make sure you select the correct drive letter from a drop-down. Now click the OK button to begin the setup. Version 5 of BackTrack is around 2 gigabytes. The download time will vary depending on your connection speed. After the files finish downloading, it will install BackTrack on the USB drive. Once setup completes, click the Exit button. You now have the necessary knowledge to use Unetbootin to create a bootable USB drive with a Linux operating system on it. Now you just need to place the USB drive in the system you need to recover, and then set that system in the BIOS to be able to boot to the USB device.